Hello YouTube friends. If you are watching this video, it means that you are also full of rechargeable batteries without a proper charger. There are many inexpensive products that can charge different types of batteries in different voltages, but I need them now and I don't want to wait 2 weeks for shipping. If you have the time and patience to get to the end of the video, I will explain how I created a super easy to make charger using components we all nerds have at home. In the meantime, subscribe to my channel and follow me on Telegram, Instagram, or wherever. Yuppie! Let's see what we've got here. The first battery is an Energizer AA nickel metal hydride with a capacity of a remarkable 2500 mAh. Then we have a 1000 mAh Duracell AA. This is also a nickel metal hydride battery. Finally, this one here in the same color as my gloves is a Panasonic AA nickel metal hydride battery also, rated at 550 mAh. These batteries are pretty old and I have no idea how much charge they have left. The Panasonic gets about 640 millivolts. The Energizer gets close to 900 millivolts. Lastly, the Duracell. Lastly, the Duracell gets to 700 millivolts. I usually consider this type of battery dead at about 800 millivolts, so we can say that all three are pretty much down. The first method I can think of to charge all these batteries is to set the power supply to 1.5 volts with a very low current. In this case, I set the current to 20 milliamps. I usually use small magnets like these to conveniently connect the wires to the battery. Battery poles are usually ferromagnetic, so magnets will hold well. Of course, using a proper battery holder will provide more stability. Turning on the power supply, we see that the charge current is 14 milliamps. Definitely very low. It will take many hours, perhaps days, to fully charge the battery. Technically, it is as if we were charging the battery at a current similar to its self-discharge rate. Surfing the internet, I discovered that this process is often used and is called trickle charging. It can be used to maintain the voltage of batteries already at maximum charge or, as in our case, to slowly recharge a discharged battery. Be very careful. This method is perfect for nickel metal hydride and nickel cadmium batteries. It is not safe at all for lithium batteries. Now that I have found out that what I am doing is safe and will not explode anything, we can make a simple and effective circuit to charge our batteries at low current. Once again, YouTube came to the rescue. The fantastic YouTuber Big Clive suggests a circuit that is as simple as it is brilliant. Of course, I thank this amazing creator and I highly recommend you to follow and support him. Quickly analyzing his idea, we can see that there is a diode that is used to prevent the passive discharge of the battery. After that, there is a 120 ohm resistor and of course the battery to be charged. In parallel to the resistor, Clive adds an LED, I assume to signal that the battery is charging. I am looking forward to testing this circuit. First, let's get our breadboard and some resistors. Since I do not have 120 ohm resistors, I will use two 100 ohm resistors and two 22 ohm resistors in series. Let's not forget the diode. I use a 1N4007. We also need an LED. I have my white LEDs. If you don't have a desktop power supply like I do, you can use a simple 5-volt USB charger. To shorten the video, I have already soldered the 100-ohm resistors together with the 22-ohm resistors. Although the resulting resistance will be 122 ohms instead of 120 ohms, I don't think it will be a problem. Let's start placing our components. First, the power wires. Then we take our diode and connect it to the positive terminal of the power supply. Be careful not to get the direction wrong. I place the LED right after the diode. Again, we have to pay attention to the polarity, because the LED is a diode. Finally, we place the resistors. One from the right after the LED, and the other from the right after the diode. Maybe this diagram is clearer. To connect the battery, I use two jumpers and the usual magnets. Turning on the power, as in all my videos, nothing works. What is the problem? Maybe the LED with the wrong polarity. Still nothing works. Here is the answer. The problem is the ground, simply the ground was not connected. If we put the LED in the right position, everything works perfectly. Yuppie! Looking closely at the circuit, we see that the LED is on and produces a very low light. The current delivered by the power supply is 17 milliamps. Right now it is 4:40 p.m. on the 22nd of June. Let's see how our circuit behaves over the next few hours. At the beginning of the experiment, our 2500 mAh Energizer nickel metal hydride battery had a voltage of about 900 millivolts. After 5.5 hours, the voltage had risen to an impressive 1.35 volts. This is a good start. Reconnecting the battery, we see that the current is still 17 milliamps. About 14 hours into the charge. The voltage is 1.37 volts. It has risen very slightly. It is June 24th and 45 hours of charging have passed. The voltage has also risen to almost 1.39 volts. I have noticed that the LED is getting less and less bright. We have charged this battery for 116 hours and the charge current has dropped to 13 milliamperes. If you look closely, the LED is completely off. Now we need to disconnect the battery and prepare the multimeter. We measured the voltage and it was 1.43 volts. The battery datasheet suggests 1.45 volts as the maximum charge voltage, so we can say that we have charged our battery safely and correctly. We're at the end of this project, and I want to share some thoughts about what we've built. The circuit I've shown you has a lot of potential. It costs almost nothing and doesn't stress or heat our batteries. It's not the fastest, but we all have to accept that perfection isn't always attainable. I hope you've enjoyed this content, and please remember that supporting my channel is simple and doesn't cost much. You can subscribe in a second, connect with me on Telegram, or click on links in the video description. Thanks, everyone, for your support. Have a great day. Ciao, ciao.